Welcome to the session. I am Mr.Pravin, Yalappa, Kumbhar. Today we want to see design of downlinks. The learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of the session, student will be able to explain the concept of downlink design in satellite communication. The content of these topics are noise figure and noise temperature, G/2 ratio for earth stations, design of downlinks and link budgets. Noise figure and noise temperature. Noise figure is frequently used to specify the noise generated within a device. The operational noise figure is defined by the following formula. The noise figure is defined as ratio of signal to noise ratio at the input to the signal to noise ratio at the output. To convert this noise figure to noise temperature T, because noise temperature is more useful in satellite communication system, the relationship between the noise figure and noise temperature is defined as T is equal to T0 in bracket NF minus 1, where NF is noise figure. T0 is the reference temperature used to calculate the standard noise figure, and the value for T0 is 290 Kelvin. This is a table which comparison of noise temperature and noise figure. Now, for noise temperature at 0 Kelvin, the noise figure is 0 dB. For the different specific temperature, here we calculate the noise figure in dB. G/T ratio for earth stations. The link equation can be rewritten in terms of C/N at the earth station is C/N is equal to PT GT GR divided by K TS BN into lambda by 4 pi R bracket square. Now this equation we want to simplify, we get as PT GT divided by K BN into lambda by 4 pi R bracket square into GR by TS, where GR by TS is the G/T in decibels, that is decibel per Kelvin, which specify the quality of a receiving earth station or a satellite receiving system. Now, design of downlinks. The design of any satellite communication is mainly based on the two objectives. The first one is meeting a minimum C/N ratio for a specified percentage of time. Now, the second one is carrying the maximum revenue earning traffic at minimum cost. Any satellite link can be designed very large antenna to achieve the high C/N ratio under all condition. Now for the high C/N ratio, here we use the large antenna, therefore obviously the cost for that will be the increases. The art of a good system design is depends on the best compromise of system parameters that meets the specification at the lowest cost. Now all the satellite communication links are affected by the rain attenuation. Now we have taken example for the different bands which the rain affected at that satellite communication. Now for example, at the 6/4 GHz band, the rain attenuation is small. But now we compare that 14/11 GHz band, that is also called as a KU band, the rain attenuation is more as compared to 6/4 GHz. Now at the 30/20 GHz, that is also called a KA band, the rain attenuation is more as compared to the KU band. And obviously it is also even more as compared to the 6/4 GHz band. C-links here can be designed to achieve the 99.99%, because here rain attenuation we can consider that factor is 1 or 2 dB. And for this achievement, the time requirement is 0.01% of the year, that is equivalent to the 52 minutes. Now here rain attenuation statistics is not stable. Again, how is the C-links is designed? The same procedure we use for the K-links can be designed, but here we cannot be achieved the 99.99% because here rain attenuation is 10 or 20 dB. And again here same time we use, that is 0.01% of the year, that is 52 minutes. Now if you observe these two links we designed, here the C-links is used for the real time and K is used for the another purpose. Now For the telephone traffic needs real-time channels that are maintained for the duration of a call. Therefore, we use C or KU band. Now, for the internet transmission, is less affected by short outage. Therefore, we use KA band suited for internet access. Link budgets. CN ratio calculation is simplified by the use of link budgets. A link budget is a tabular method for evaluating the received power and noise power in a radio link. Link budgets invariably use decibel units for all quantities so that signal and noise power can be calculated by addition and subtraction. The link budget calculated at an individual transponder, repeated for the each of the individual links. Therefore, in a two-way satellite communication, there are total repeated means four times. Therefore, in a two-way satellite communication link, we use four separate links, each require a calculation of a CN ratio. Now, the overall CN ratio is calculated with the help of uplink as well as the downlink CN ratio. Therefore, when a bent pipe transponder is used, the uplink and downlink CN ratio must be combined to give an overall CN. The calculation of C by N in a satellite link is based on the two equations. The first equation is on the received signal power and second one is receiver noise power. Now, the received carrier power in dB watts as, now here pause the video and recall the received carrier power. Okay, now the received carrier power is equal to EIRP plus GR minus LP minus LA minus LTA minus LRA. The unit of this received carrier power is dB watt, where EIRP is equal to 10 log to the base 10 PT GT. That's the unit of EIRP is dB watt. GR is equal to 10 log to the base 10 4 pi A divided by lambda square. The unit of that GR is dB. Path loss LP is equal to 10 log base 10 4 pi R by lambda bracket square. LA is equal to attenuation in atmosphere. LTA is equal to losses associated with transmitting antenna. LRA is equal to losses associated with receiving antenna. A noise power PN refers to the output terminal of the antenna, where PN is equal to K into TS into BN. That unit of that PN is watts, where TS is a receiving terminal with a system noise temperature in Kelvin. BN is a noise bandwidth in Hertz. The receiving system noise power is usually written in decibel unit as N is equal to K plus TS plus BN. The unit of that noise power is dB watt, where K is a Boltzmann constant. TS is the system noise temperature in dB Kelvin. BN is the noise bandwidth of the receiver in dB Hertz. Now, the question is, an earth station antenna has a diameter of 30 meter, has an overall efficiency of 68% and is used to receive a signal at 4150 megahertz. At this frequency, the system noise temperature is 79 Kelvin, where the antenna points at the satellite at an elevation angle of 28 degree. What is the earth station G by T ratio under these conditions? Now, basically in this question, I have to calculate the G by T ratio. Now, for the calculation of a G by T ratio, first of all, we calculate the gain, and after that calculate this temperature, and after the calculation of this gain and temperature, we can calculate the G by T ratio. Now, first of all, we have to write the given quantity. What is the given quantity? At 4150 megahertz, lambda is equal to 0.0723 meter. Then, the formula for the gain is Na into, in bracket, pi by d by lambda, bracket complete square. Now, put the values of this in this equation, we get this Na means efficiency is 0.68, that is a 68% is provided in this question. Therefore, we write here 0.68 into pi into this d means what, diameter, that is a 30 meter. We have to write here 30 divided by lambda. So lambda at this megahertz, the lambda is 0.0723. We have to put here and the bracket square. And after this solving, after the simplification of this one, we get 1.16 into 10 raised to 6. Now convert this into the dB. Why? Because if we convert into this dB, here we calculation of a G by T ratio. For this calculation of a G by T ratio, if we calculate in the dB, simply we subtract that one and we get this ratio. Converting TS into the dBK, because here it is a calculated in dB, therefore the TS is also calculated we want into the dB. For the calculation of a TS into dB, 10 log 79, that is gives the 19 dBK. Now we have to calculate here G by T ratio. Now the G by T ratio in the decibel we calculate by simply the subtraction of T from G. Therefore G by T is equal to 60.6 minus 19, we get 41.6 dB per Kelvin. That is a G by T ratio. The reference for this topic is, thank you.